Good morning, gentlemen. Hope you all are fine. So far, we have been studying the chapters from history. Now, we will study some chapters from civics. In this chapter, we will study about the salient features of Indian Constitution. Specifically, we study about Indian citizenship, we study about universal adult franchise, we study about fundamental right and fundamental duties. Let us discuss each of these in detail. We know in India we follow single citizenship. That means irrespective of a person's place of living, he was given only one citizenship, that is the citizenship of his country. Whether he lives in Karnataka, in Tamil Nadu, in Madhya Pradesh or in Maharashtra, he was not given the citizenship of those respective states. Instead, he was given the citizenship of the country. That is called single citizenship. The single citizenship is an important feature of Indian Constitution. There are many countries that provide dual citizenship. For example, America. America provides dual citizenship to its citizens. That means an American citizen is a citizen of America as well as a citizen of the state in which he lives. Such a citizenship is called a dual citizenship. On the other hand, in India, the Constitution provides us single citizenship. The makers of the Constitution specifically mentioned about the single citizenship because they wanted to maintain the unity and fraternity of India. They did not want to promote any kind of separatist ideas. So, the single citizenship was instituted in the Indian Constitution. In 2003, the Parliament has passed the Citizenship Amendment Act. According to the Citizenship Amendment Act of 2003, people of Indian origin also were given certain privileges that an Indian citizen enjoys. The Indian citizens enjoy a lot of privileges granted by the Constitution. They can participate in elections, they can contest elections, they can buy property, they can start business. Like that, a large number of privileges are enjoyed by the Indian citizens. Similarly, the Citizenship Amendment Act of 2003 granted people of Indian origins to have certain privileges. People of Indian origin means the people, those who migrated to other countries before January 26, 1950 are called people of Indian origin. They have certain privileges like the citizens of India, except the universal adult franchise. That means those people are not allowed to cast their votes in any of the elections that is held in India. Except that the people of Indian origin too have all other privileges like a normal citizen of India. The second feature of Indian constitution is the Universal Adult Franchise or UAF. Very few people of the world enjoys Universal Adult Franchise. It means all people living in India, irrespective of their caste, their creed, their religion, their educational qualification, are allowed to cast their vote in elections only if they attain 18 years of age. All the people, those who are 18 years or more, can cast their vote irrespective of their educational qualification, irrespective of their social standard, irrespective of their sex, irrespective of their religion, caste or creed. This special power is called a universal adult franchise. The constitution put forward only one condition, that is the person should attain 18 years of age. This special power is not granted to a large number of people in the world. In certain countries, ladies are not allowed to cast their vote. In some countries, only the people, those who pay taxes, are allowed to cast their vote. But in India, everyone who attained 18 years of age can cast their votes in elections. This power, or this is called Universal Adult Franchise. The constitution grants certain special rights to its citizens. These special rights are called fundamental rights. There are generally 6 fundamental rights which are applicable to every citizen of India. And there's a 7th fundamental right, the right to education. It is applicable only to the children, those who are up to 14 years of age. It is their fundamental right to get education. So these fundamental rights are granted to us by the constitution. They are called as fundamental rights because the government cannot take these special rights from its citizens. And in any case, if a citizen feels that his fundamental right, any of his fundamental right is violated by any law passed by the government, he has the freedom to approach the court for the restoration of that fundamental right, which is called a right to constitutional remedies. Thus, the fundamental right is the essential conditions for the all-round well-being of an individual. All the people of the world do not enjoy these rights. We are lucky that we enjoy the fundamental right. The fundamental rights are mentioned in the part 3 of the constitution. They give recognition to equality and dignity of every citizen. While the constitution has granted us certain rights, it demands certain duties from its citizens. These duties are called fundamental duties. Fundamental rights and fundamental duties are somewhat like two sides of a coin. Fundamental rights are the rights which are granted to the citizens, whereas fundamental duties are the duties that every citizen is supposed to perform. When the constitution was originally composed, fundamental duties were not mentioned in it. It was added to the constitution through the 42nd amendment in 1976. They are inserted in part 4 of the constitution. The fundamental duties are inserted in the constitution with the view to make the citizens aware of their social and economic obligations, to protect and awaken the people of their cultural heritage, and to strengthen the national harmony. These are the primary aims of adding fundamental duty in the part 4 of the constitution. So far we have seen about the features of Indian constitution. We studied about single citizenship, we studied about universal adult franchise, we studied about fundamental rights and fundamental duties. Hope these concepts are clear to you. If you have any doubt, you are free to contact and I am ready to clear your doubts. It's enough for today. Thank you.